I'm back with not just any ordinary video, it is the What's on My iPhone 6 video. And if you don't know, the iPhone 6 came out... Oh my gosh, when did it come out? It was exactly a week from today. Today is the... Sorry, I like don't remember. Today's the 26th. So whatever the last Friday before that was, that's when the iPhone 6 came out. Shows how much I know. But, basically, I got my iPhone 6 from Costco, and I wasn't even intending to really get a new phone. I had the iPhone 4 previously, which I loved. Like, I don't know, it did everything I needed it to do. I had no complaints with the 4, but it was just time to upgrade, so that's what I did. But basically, Costco had the 16 gig gold, which is this. And they didn't have any other colors, but I can't complain because the gold was actually my first choice. So I was pretty lucky that they had the gold. And the funny thing is, Costco doesn't even display the iPhone 6, so if you just walk right past, you wouldn't even know that they have the iPhone 6 for sale. You would just assume that they have the 5 because they have the 5S on display. So many people just walk right by, but my dad asked, and the guy was like, no, we do carry the iPhone 6. So I was like, oh, time to upgrade, and that's what I did. And I think a lot of people forget that Costco has a little cell phone kiosk booth, because everyone's, like, in a rush in Costco, so I think they walk right past it and don't even realize that they have the iPhone 6. But, so that's just a tip. If you guys are looking at getting the iPhone 6, check out your Costco, or anything like that. So, yeah, wow, it was upside down. Today's Friday, and I'm just kind of like... I don't even know. But yeah, so far so good. I'm really, really loving it. It's definitely such an upgrade from the iPhone 4. It's much bigger, it's much thinner. I just really, really love it. Like, the iPhone 4 is literally the size of this, of the LCD screen, which is crazy. And I don't have the iPhone 4 with me right now because my sister's using it because her phone's broken. So I'm being a nice sister and letting her use my old phone. So yeah, sorry for the long intro, but I'm really, really, really excited about showing you guys what's on my iPhone. So let's get started. Alright, so this is my iPhone 6, as you can see. And I have a clear silicone case on my iPhone, which I really like because I can still see the gold color. But I'm probably going to get another case eventually. And I also have a matte screen protector, which I would recommend because they're a lot better than regular screen protectors because, as you can see, you can't really notice my fingerprints, which I love. So, yeah, let's get started. This is my lock screen. It's just this really cute background that I found on Pinterest, and it just says hello. And I only have 2 pages of apps. And I like it that way. I don't like having more than 2 pages. I just like keeping things organized in folders and all of that. Alright, so I'm going to start with the first page and kind of work my way from the top to the bottom. Basically, on the first page, it's a lot of stock apps, apps that already came with the iPhone that I don't really use often. Alright, so the first app that I have is Calendar, which obviously comes with the iPhone. Next to it, I have Photos, I have Camera, iTunes Store, which I never use iTunes because I just don't use iTunes at all. I have Maps, Videos, Clock, Notes, Reminders, and a new app that came with the iPhone 6 is this Health app, which I have yet to use, so I'm not really sure how it works, but it says day, week, month, year, so I'm guessing you can, like, put in some information, yeah. Right next to it, I have Weather, and in here I have a folder that says Extras. And once again, this is just apps that already came with the iPhone. Compass, Tips, Voice Memos, Contacts, Podcasts, Music, iBooks, Passbook, Newsstand, and Stocks. So the first page of my iPhone is pretty boring because a lot of it is just apps that come with the iPhone. I have Calculator, I have Fugicate, which is really, really nice if... I'm not a calorie counter, but if you want to know kind of what you're eating, or you want to know if it's good for you or not, this is a perfect app. You can just scan a food item, and it will tell you on a letter grade scale if it's good or bad for you on like a A to F grade scale. Right next to it, I have Settings, and then the App Store. I have FaceTime, Wallpapers. I believe the app is called Wallpapers HD. This is a perfect app if you want really nice quality wallpapers. And you can just see that the color quality of these wallpapers are really, really nice. And so I get a lot of my... Okay, let's Oh no, okay. See, this is one thing that happens when you have free apps. You get all these ads. Okay, let's close this out. Bye-bye. Alright. So yeah, you get like really cool apps, and yeah, I really enjoy that app, so I would highly recommend it if you would like some nice quality wallpapers. Alright, the next I have my period tracker calendar because, yeah, Mother Nature. I also have the Waze GPS app, which is super helpful if I ever need to know where I'm going or if I'm lost. This app is perfect. And then I have my USAA account. And then at the bottom, I just have my four, I would say, pretty important apps. I have phone, mail, messages, and Safari. So that is all that is on my first page of my phone. The second page gets a little bit more fun. I have Pinterest, which I am obsessed with Pinterest. If you do not have Pinterest, you need to make one. It's just really awesome for inspiration and DIY ideas. It really gets you inspired to like do something, you know, change your outfit or your style or a DIY project. This is just the perfect app, and I love this app. So you guys can follow me if you want. I am Sydney Jones, and I'm just a girl who spends too much time on Pinterest. What can I say? Alright, and then I have my Instagram, which, who doesn't have Instagram? My Instagram is just like my YouTube, All Things Sid, so definitely follow me there if you guys want to stay connected and all of that. And then I have Twitter, but yeah, you guys should follow me on Twitter. I will have all my social media down below if you guys want to follow me there. I have Facebook, which is my personal Facebook. I'm sorry, I don't have any other Facebook. I have Tumblr, which I don't use as much. Once again, I'm a Pinterest girl. I love Pinterest. I have Vine because I love going on Vine to watch like really funny videos. I have YouTube, of course, and I have Overdrive, which I have mentioned in my previous What's in My iPhone video and my What's on My iPad. I can't talk today. But I really like this app. You sync it to whatever library is nearest you. Mine is the Maryland library. I don't have anything on my bookshelf because I haven't checked anything out, but basically it's a virtual library. It's all through an app. So if I want to find a book, I can do that. So just randomly, I don't even know what Polly is, but you just hit borrow and then the book will be in your bookshelf. So let me show you. So yeah, if I were to check out this book, I would just hit download and then it would go to my bookshelf. But this is great if you do not want to pay for ebooks, because this is just the same system as a library. So you just return it all through an app. So it's really cool because you don't have to actually get up and go to the library. I also have Gmail and I have E-Online just to keep up with my Hollywood gossip. So I check that once in a while. I have Dropbox because it's great if you have bigger files. You can put it on Dropbox. And yeah, it's really helpful. For music, I have Shazam and Spotify. I just discovered Spotify and I am literally obsessed. I was using Pandora before and I do not know why, because Spotify is where it's at. I also have music download, which I'm not really liking right now. I think with the update, I just don't like it as much, so I lately have just been using Spotify. Alright, the next folder is my lifestyle folder. I have a lot of shopping apps and things like that. I have eBay, Zulily, Hotlook, Yelp, Care.com, Groupon, and PayPal. So this is kind of like my important stuff right there too. And then my photography folder, I have a lot. I have 9 apps. I have Afterlight, ViscoCam. ViscoCam is one of the best free photo editing apps, so if you want a free one, get ViscoCam. I have Image Editor, Square Ready, which is where you get the white border, and I have PicStitch, PicFX, Over, which is like a text. You can add text on top of pictures. I have iMovie if I ever wanted to edit a video. And this is a new photo editing app that I recently downloaded. It's called Pomelo, and I've actually not used it, but it looked really nice. So it's free, so if you guys want to check that one out too, you definitely should. Alright, so next is my games folder, which is pretty sad. I only have Family Feud and Heads Up, but that's just because I have an iPad, so most of my games are on my iPad. And since this is only a 16 gig, I don't want like a whole bunch of games on here. And my last app is Grad Guru, which is amazing if you're a community college student. I'm not going to open it because it's going to show the college I go to, but if you go to a community college, this will sync it with your college, and it basically reminds you of any deadlines or tests or anything coming up, so it's kind of like a mini reminder for you for your school, which is really, really cool. Alright everyone, that is the end of the What's on My iPhone 6 video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Also, if you guys have any apps or things like that you want to share with me or that you think I should check out, leave it in the comments so I can check it out. And I think that's about it for today, so I will see you guys next time. Bye!